Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, first allow me to mix my language Malay and English. Okay, because we have a short time, so I go further into the main course. Okay, me and Prof. Mirza do a research regarding an investigation of learning strategies, emotion engagement, and performing in recall, classification, and visualization in immersive visual reality. All that application. Okay. Next, okay, kita tengok dulu. VR tu benda. Eh, senang kan cerita. Okay, VR is a computer-generated environment that can be get through with three categories of method. First one is non-immersive. Okay, non-immersive ni benda yang berkaitan dengan satu monitor, just one monitor, direct approach, such as desktop, laptop, and mobile phone. And then second method is semi-immersive, which means we have to get a large monitor or projector that is semi-immersive, such as 4D, 5D cinema. Kalau siapa pernah pergi dinosaurs punya 3D, 4D punya kan, naik roller coaster sampai like that, it is a 4D semi-immersive VR. Okay, for my case, I more focus into immersive visual reality. Okay, immersive visual reality, you need use HMD. Ini sample yang paling kodi sangat lah. Tadi paling jimat. Cardboard, Google Cardboard. I think the price maybe 10 to 25 ringgit. Okay, you all boleh dapat dekat mana-mana. So mungkin harga dia kalau lain nak lagi best, lagi mahal lah, macam Oculus VR, gear, Samsung Gear VR or something like that. Okay, so kita okay, we have a conceptual framework that we combine from Gagné, Medley, and Fraser. With me, we have collective working here, and then with emotion framework, and then make it new platform, information processing model for audio visual learning. Okay, let's skip yang ini dulu sebab ini bukan main course kita. Okay, then next time, okay, problem statement. Sebab saya punya research is about nak tahu kalau kata kita gunakan immersive visual reality to the students, how connective dia punya connective, and how apa ni dia trigger high spatial and low spatial. Okay, so Zaki kata spatial ability effect learners with high spatial ability student better academic achievement. Tapi Zaki test pada non-immersive, bukan immersive, which means my case immersive visual reality. Okay, so kat sini dia punya problem lah. So I will figure out apa immersive visual reality for spatial ability. Okay, ini research identity. Okay, so next one dia kita lah, sebab semua orang pun tengok jam kan. Okay, so research identity is to first investigate the ease of HMD. Okay, and then to investigate the view technique. Tengok atas ke bawah macam mana the view technique kan. Okay, and then the learning strategy, maksudnya bila dia tengok benda tu, apa yang dia dapat, macam mana dia nak absorb information. And then for level of emotion engagement, which means kalau kata dia tengok benda ni, dia rasa takut, gembira ke, enjoyment, miss, something like that. And then finally, estimated performance. Satu, information record, which means lepas dia dah tengok semua ni, so dia akan pergi ke, kita akan tengok performance dia, adakah baik dalam information record, memory record. Then adakah dia baik dalam classification skill, which means dia boleh kategorikan apa yang dia tengok tu, dia letak pada posisi yang betul. And then third one is visualization skill, which means dia boleh figure benda yang dia dah tengok tu You boleh lukis balik. Something like that. Okay. In just one minute je. Okay, this one is okay. Ni saya punya methodology instrument. Okay, ini dia punya flow macam ni. First, I will select 40% participant of group, which means university student yang sama ada dah lepas bekerja atau masih masih study. And then daripada tu, saya akan bagi special ability test using Bennett, Seashaw and Westman. So, daripada situ saya akan figure out high and low. So, daripada high and low, saya akan pilih men high and low, and then women high and low, special. Okay, daripada situ saya akan bagi diorang tengok that type of space, true name. Tapi sebenarnya bukan yang ni, saya pakai open, Samsung ni, open history. Maksudnya dia tengok lebih wow lah kan, nice. So, this, bila dah tengok, so kita akan ada benda ni. Satu, kita akan bagi test, kita nak tahu performance dia. Sama ada dia boleh recall, sama ada dia boleh classification ataupun dia boleh visualize balik apa yang dia tengok. Lepas tu kita akan adakan interview. Dan interview tu ada mengenai benda ni, ease of use, lalu view technique, learning certificate employed, emotion engagement. Kita tanya balik apa yang dia buat. Dalam masa sama yang juga ke person dia. So ini participant characteristic lah. Okay, kita start. The finding. Okay, ni dah kita masuk finding lah sebab tadi ada 5 finding kan. First one is ease of use for special ability. Apa yang kita dapat? Okay, both of the group said that HMD is easy to wear. The instruction of method of space is easy to follow. But the text in visual content is blurry. Memang blurry lah sebab dia jauh kan. And then sometimes they feel uncomfortable because when they use more head movement, so aggressive, dia orang akan rasa disoriented. Okay, and then akan closure. Okay, so okay, untuk high spatial dia kenapa? Okay, sorry, high spatial dia punya soft view dia excited, but terus pasien dia lebih kepada macam nak try. Okay, high pasien dia lebih kepada education punya purpose. Manakala low ni dia macam ada tengok dia macam pasien kalau ada. Okay, ni untuk gender lah. Okay, both of the group sama juga macam high low pasien. Okay, main participant focus to visual element. Element, but juga tapi sebenarnya lebih pada audio. Terbeza. Tapi pun kita dah tahu terbeza dia. Sebab laki dia tak boleh layan dia tak layan pun audio. Dia lebih pada visual content. Manakala female ni dia lebih macam dia nak mendengar, nak dengar music sambil ada. Okay, ini so ini discussion lah. So macam saya cakap tadi, semua group. Spatial dengan gender masing-masing rasa nausea, rasa discomfort dan rasa lebih half of the VR talk. Okay, so okay, ini finding untuk yang kedua, view technique. View technique macam saya cakap tadi, kita tengok macam mana, kita nak tengok dia macam mana cara dia tengok benda ni. So kebanyakan okay, high spatial akan use extensive. Maksudnya kita akan bagi satu chat, rotating chat, maksudnya dia boleh buat apa saja dia suka. So memang high spatial guna sepenuhnya, atas, bawah, kiri, kanan, tengok semua. So kejap lagi rasa pening, bumper. Lepas tu low spatial dia guna limited head body movement. Maksudnya dia duduk sekali kanan, lepas tu jerit. Sebab low spatial ni dia tak, dia macam mudah disoriented, rasa nausea. Okay, okay, di untuk gender pula lah. Gender, female macam biasa, agresif, bagi kursi dia atas, pusing-pusing dia. And then female participant pula limited body movement but focus on the content or the presentation. Ni male, dia agresif saja, tapi dia tak absorb pun information. Female, walaupun dia guna limit body movement, tapi dia baca setiap satu benda yang duduk dalam konteks tu, which is good lah. Okay, jadi discussion macam saya cakap tadi. Okay, okay, ini untuk strategi yang ke apa? Finding yang ketiga, learning strategy. Okay, kita nak tengok apa benda yang dia orang dapat daripada apa? Tentang office VR application. Okay, high spatial. Dia cakap dia boleh fokus pada detail of the object. Okay. Tentang outer space ni, dia punya tool adalah mengenai solar system. Kat dalam tu ada bawah, ada bulan, ada awan, sambil ada lampu. So, dia boleh detect benda tu. Tapi, itu special, kenapa? Dia boleh nampak benda besar je. Macam, dia nampak apa matahari. Wah, oh, misalnya matahari. Tapi, high special, dia boleh nampak apa black dot dekat matahari tu. Dia boleh tanya, ni tu apa? Dengan low spatial tak cakap, tak cukup. So beza dia high low spatial. Okay, so by gender, okay. By gender, kali ni female lagi overcome daripada male. Female, dia lebih critical approach in dealing with the visual evolving aspect of size, color, limited shape and surface. Manakala male, keep all the detail. Dia nak action dia lebih. Oh, I nak want to touch case, I nak glove yang boleh interact with the VR content, content something like that. So, female bagi ni duduk kat situ dia biar dia boleh absorb information. Berbanding lelaki ni dia banyak cakap. Dia nak nak ni nak tu apa semua kan. Okay. Okay. Jadi saya cakap tadi lah, female learners were more systematic and organized sebab dia boleh absorb information dan simpan dalam semantic memory, episodic memory macam yang saya tunjuk dekat yang apa conceptual framework tadi. Itu yang saya sebenarnya terang kan. Okay, so kita next finding. Okay, ni adalah mengenai emotion engagement. Emotion engagement kita lebih kepada nak tengok detail atau lepas tu dia punya emotion macam something like that. Lepas ni so high low spatial both for the group feel fatigue due to nausea emotion sickness. Itu je musuh dia, rasa disoriented, nausea and emotion sickness. Tapi untuk high spatial, untuk dia berlaku benda tu dia perlukan tidur dalam 5 minit berbanding dengan low spatial 4 to 5 minit, which mean high spatial boleh boleh sustain focus and attention lebih daripada low spatial sebab total memakan masa 15 hingga 20 minit. Okay, so untuk gender, untuk gender female tired lepas 5 hingga 10 minit, kadang-kadang male 4 hingga 6. Okay, sebab apa male cepat tired? Sebab dia agresif, dia main, dia pusing, dia atas bawah. So dia cepat rasa notion. Manakala female, dia statik, tengok 180 macam tu atas bawah. So dia boleh sustain dia punya pemakanan tu lebih lama daripada dia lagi. Okay, so ini discussion lah. Okay, nampak kat situ. Ni maksudnya sekarang ni duration sebelum rasa pergi high spatial dengan female mendominasi, sustain attention in VR code. Maksudnya, kalau bagi kami dia mesti visuality untuk title of space dimenangi oleh high spatial demand. So, tengok apa benda yang jadi kalau kata diorang menangi mana ni. Okay, kan? Kami bagi, lepas dia tengok, kami bagi test untuk dia tengok bukti benda ni betul jadi ke tak. So boleh kita nampak low, high and low sama dengan dalam classification and visualization scale. Mesti sama saja, tapi dalam record sangat beza. Sebab apa? Sebab high spatial mampu untuk sustain dia punya attention and then dia boleh absorb the detail of the VR content. sangat walaupun saya pernah ada participant yang cakap saya nampak galaksi ke hujung tu, padahal saya tengok banyak kali tak nampak. Sangat wow. Okay. Okay, next one is by ini untuk gender lah. Male and female. Okay, ini berbeza macam tadi. High spatial dia lebih kepada recall. Spatial ability dia punya beza adalah recall. Manakala untuk gender dia berbeza untuk visualization. Ini bermakna male and female sama dalam recall and classification. Manakala female dia maksudnya dia berjaya mendominasi male dalam visualization. With me dia cantas previous punya saya punya research yang saya baca lah. Kita agak terkejut juga sebab female yang mendominasi visualization. Visualization maksudnya melakar balik apa benda yang dia tengok, boleh mencerita balik satu per satu daripada apa yang dia tengok. Lepas tu dia boleh energy benda tu. Okay. So secara discussion ya, sebab apa ini berlaku, high spatial dia more attentive to the detail presented. Manakala female dia outperform male in visual skill sebab dia sustain the attention. Sebab dia guna benda tu, dia boleh absorb lagi lama. Dan female is easily distract. Dia nak interactiveness, dia banyak cakap tapi dia tak absorb pun benda, tak absorb information yang ada dalam content. Okay, this is my limitation of study lah. Okay, disebabkan saya punya research ni sangat terhad, saya pun post graduate, so sangat limit. So benda ni sepatutnya memerlukan satu participant yang ramai. So benda ni kalau saya buat kualitatif, tapi sebenarnya benda ni kuantitatif. So benda ni harus dalam group yang ramai. So saya punya kajian mungkin tak boleh nak generalize to the population, belum lagi. Mungkin saya boleh sambung benda ni untuk PhD saya insyaAllah lah kan. So sekarang ni saya punya recommendation and future research is publication ni harus lebih longer duration of engagement, employ bigger samples and statistic analysis. Tak boleh tak buat ni, dia kena more to test, something like that. Okay, so as macam apa ni, Prof. Dr. Roslan M. Muhammad Idrus cakap dalam buku tadi, dia cakap tadi dalam buku booklet tu kan, dia kata technology is becoming more immersive, more seamless, and this has given rise to a new classroom. Guess what? This is new classroom. Benda ni adalah new classroom. And then memang benda ni kosong, tapi bila dia attach kepada computer, mobile phone and anything cloud, something like that, that's a new future. So saya ni youngster, so baru lagi dalam dunia benda ni. So I think it is a future and then we going to break the barrier. Okay, thank you for me.
I have used this device from International Medical University.
I see. Okay.
And it's very difficult for our students to bring them to operation theater to use this device.
Okay.
And where they could actually move around and can see. So what is your recommendation?
What's
how we could engage longer? What you said is very right. Even the first time I used, I feel also
busy.
So what's your recommendation?
Recommendation on avoiding busyness or something?
Yeah, and increasing the engagement of students.
Okay, to avoid the busyness, I think just one method, repeatable method, but which means you use to repeat the view, something like that. Okay, because two person, first time and several time user. Several time user is less more easy than a first time. So more repeat viewing is more better in avoiding busyness and leisure. Okay. And then for the subject I think is okay. From my opinion, this is better in history and science, something something like that, medical, medical, something like that, because we need to engage with more front to front, macam mana? Depan depan maksudnya, laboratory, okay, face to face, such as, okay, surgery, so we not not at that role. So with this, we can see how it being operated and something like that. Yeah. That's it for my
maybe one more question.
Hello. Hello,
sir. Thank you very much, Mr. Omar Ajay.